don't spend a lot of time at home because of our dreams. And home then becomes this ultimate dream that I guess I've been yearning for. And it's this feeling that I constantly wish and want to always be a part of. And just because I've grown so much, I left home at such a young age. All I have left is the memory and the feeling of home. But the place home is no longer the same because I've grown so much, and the meaning of home is no longer the same, but it is a moment that you kind of hold on to, and that is what I wanted to kind of express in the work, that feeling of oneness with home. What I wanted to also kind of illustrate in my work is how the female form and the male form are not uniform, in a way that women are seen, or rather bare-breasted women are seen in a hyper-sexualized manner, and men on the other hand are seen as a sex symbol, a symbol of victory, a symbol of achievement, and that is when they are equally bare-breasted. And I think that is a kind of a topic and subject that we need to interrogate as society, to understand what it means to be truly equal and what it means to see each other with the same lens if we are equal. And that is what I wanted to explore by juxtaposing the male and the female form. With Africans, our greatest currency is our understanding of who we are, and I think the work kind of speaks to that. And no matter how much the West can mine and dig from us, that understanding of who we are is so spiritual and so deep that no one can ever take it away from us. And even when our culture is appropriated and misappropriated, it is still our culture at the end of the day, and it is up to us to own it and to celebrate it, instead of having endless conversations and debates about cultural appropriation. We should be actually celebrating it.